Hello, hello. Perfidious Pete here, dancing a jig atop the graves of the last of the X-Alt forces in XCOM, The Long War. And if you think I'm going to stop my celebration anytime soon, you're out of your damned mind. In fact, when I finish this gravetop jig, I'm probably going to whip out my dong and do a little gravetop pissing as well. Because while no amount of corpse and grave defiling is going to be sufficient to account for the aggravation that X-Alt has given me over the course of this series, still, one hell of a catharsis. And considering the fact that not only is X-Alt finally done for, but that the mission to exterminate them also went pretty well, I feel entitled to wallowing in my own crapulence a little. We really did a pretty good job. I mean, the mission didn't go perfectly, of course. Mata Hari did wind up in a hospital after a Mary Sue sniper shot a hole clean through her middle. But apart from Mata, the team's overall strategy of scourging the earth with fire and explosives and then stomping X-Alt as they scattered from their dissolving cover like roaches from the lights coming on worked pretty damn well. If I'm honest, it was kind of beautiful and damn near brought a tear to my eye. Well, I mean, that last part was a lie. It didn't actually bring a tear to my eye. This is just a video game. I mean, it's not like I'm watching Pretty in Pink or The Princess Bride or something that legitimately makes me weep. But despite my lack of actual tears, still pretty stoked about the win. Less stoked about Mata's 26 days in the hospital, but still pretty stoked about the win. And hopefully the team and I can carry that positive energy forward into our next mission. I mean, we probably won't. We're probably going to wind up more brokenhearted than poor Prince Humperdinck, but a man can dream. A man can dream. So let's get to scanning and see if we can keep this dream alive. Troopers coming back on duty. Atlas King, Tomo Egozen, looks like Van Dorn and Tariq, the other half of the Wonder Twins there. Abduction mission in Egypt. All right, well, let's send Rattler Kurosawa up, who is our designated go wave at the aliens in Africa, man. He's a man of action, specifically an action of waving at aliens and swearing at them over the radio, giving them the finger, that sort of stuff, because there's no way in hell we're actually going to shoot down an abduction mission. Waving is done. 2 days to supercapacitors. Can't get here quick enough. Why? There is this bug where it keeps saying stop scanning if... Alright, when it actually in fact starts scanning. I mean, it's such a minor thing, but it's really off-putting.
Commander,
alright, heavy alien resistance in Luxor, Egypt. Not to be confused with Luxor Hotel, the fantastic destination resort on the beautiful Las Vegas Strip. If you're in Las Vegas, consider staying at the Luxor. Actually, I've never had any luck at the Luxor. They have pretty tight slot machines there, and the table games are a little bit pricey, even for the Strip. I recommend staying downtown instead. Better value for your dollar, more fun, and the Fremont experience, 100% absolutely free. This message in no way brought to you by Las Vegas, Nevada. Just my personal opinion. Not sponsored. Although, Fremont Street, if you want to sponsor me, I work cheap. I mean, literally, for like pennies. So, let's get to the Luxor. I guess the Luxor probably won't be sponsoring me since I just said their hotel was kind of crummy, but calling a spade a spade. What do we want to do for a team here? We do have heavy alien resistance. We should probably come up with something respectable. I don't think we need the best of the best. We're not looking cream of the crop. We don't need the team that went in to try and woo Tommy Lee Jones and recruit them to become Men in Black, but a solid team would be reasonable, and I'm thinking Gunny Sergeant Marie, the Baker Antoinette, is a good team anchor. She can double-double as well, regular EXP, psychic EXP. I sort of like this plan. Let's make it happen. So we're going to get the Baker. We'll get her out with some Aegis armor, Gauss machine gun. Nothing fancy here, just our standard. What is the cognitive enhancer, by the way? EXP for the soldier or mech by 20% when equipped. Lance plus 5 will. We can't reverse engineer this item from manufacturing. Okay, interesting. What's a neuroregulator? Increase Psy XP soldier for this soldier by 50% when equipped. Lance plus 10 will. Now that's real interesting right there. That thing, Illuminator gun sight, what are you? 12 aim, 12 critical chance to primary weapon, confers the executioner perk as well. 10 aim, 10 critical against enemies at 50% health or less. Unable to reverse engineer that item. Man, okay, so these X-Alt items that we pulled out, they're real good. Could we do the Illuminator gun sight and the Neural Enhancer? I mean, this is real good. Now, we don't really need this on Marie Antoinette because she actually has Executioner. The Neuro Regulator, though, for that Psychic EXP, that's real tempting. In fact, yeah, we're going to do that. So let's go with the Neural Gun Link and the Neuro Regulator. And with those two combined, by your powers combined, I am Captain Planet. And also, we should definitely get the AXP we need in order to throw Marie Antoinette Baker into the tube. Also, her aim is still going to be pretty respectable. I'm liking that. I'm liking that a great deal. What else can we do? Should probably take a sniper. John Wayne, I think, is full on experience, but let me just double check me out. We don't want to take the Duke, then. Case to be made for Atlas King. In fact, Atlas King probably is going to be our scout, or possibly Ava Perone. We've got benefits for either one. Mitch Pancakes had... Yeah, actually, we should take Pancakes, because he'll level. Yeah, let's do Pancakes, then. Gunny Sergeant Mitch Pancakes Hedberg probably will not gain a regular level, but it wouldn't be out of the question for him to pick up a psychic level, and that'll be fine. Give us a chance to toss old Mitchie in the tube as well. Let's give him some Titan armor, just nothing fancy, Gauss rifle, shadow device. And that's got Mitch sorted. Mitch is locked, loaded, and ready to go. Somebody needs to be carrying that badass gun sight. That thing is really good. I'd love to give it to a sniper, but our only psychically active sniper is the Duke, and the Duke is currently not mission ready. So, who else would we need to take then? I mean, we've got, all we've got is a gunner and a scout. Let's do a medic, not Sir Ernie. A medic who isn't capped on psychic EXP, preferably, so that's gonna be Joseph the Cleaner Lister then. Let's get the Cleaner suited up, and I think we'll go Titan Armor. He is the protector, the salvation, the savior. No reason to not give him. Man, I would love to give you, not the cognitive enhancer, but this Illuminator gunsight. It's really good. Especially good for a medic, actually, but as much as I'd like to give it to you, honestly, I think the motion tracker is more vital. Sorry, JoJo. What else can we do here? I'm thinking we're going to take a infantry trooper on this mission as well. Medic, let's get a couple assaults. I don't want to go with our hardcore Abraham Lincoln. We could... I don't really think we need Teddy in the bench. I think the French maid and the old master, probably an adequate level. I mean, we do have heavy resistance, but this is only an abduction mission. In fact, sending both the old master and the French maid might be overkill, although we should be maybe focusing a little on captures. So let's focus on speed. We'll take French maid because she is a little faster than the old master. No offense, Leo, but you're getting on up in years, and well, you are slowing down a little bit as you age. It happens to the best of us. Nothing to be ashamed of, but it's best to admit when you're not the right tool for the job, and we'll save you for killing, because killing seems to be what you're good at. And instead, we'll bring in the speed demon. If we want speed, Michael Jackson, I mean, he's got speed. The man has speed. I don't know why I gave him that instead of an alloy cannon, because while he does have speed, that speed is best complemented with a shotgun. So let's go ahead and give him a little bit of shredder ammo and our other arc thrower. We'll try and pick up a capture here. If one falls into our lap, that'd be fantastic. If it's not really meant to be, I don't really want to put a whole lot of the team at risk in order to try and force it. Gunner, scout, medic, assault, assault. Well, we're going to need an engineer of some variety. Largely any engineer will do. Marie Radium Curie, something to be said for taking Miss Radium. Do we have another psychically active engineer? Tomoe Gozen. She needs to go in the tube, though, so she's a bad choice. Louis Anthrax Pasteur also needs to go in the tube, so again, not a fantastic choice. Elizabeth Tudor is not good enough. Sorry, Liz, but I mean, it is what it is. You know, we could take Saeed and Fatima. I think we gotta do this. So, you know what, Joseph Lister? I mean, I'm sorry about this, but I gotta kick you off the team, pal. It's been a while since you've been out to clean, and cleaning is what a good Joseph Lister does. The man invented antiseptic surgery, after all. But we need the psychic powerhouses to be powerfully psychic, and if we're gonna get them up to powerhouse levels, they gotta go on missions. Also, it's not like you were doing anything, really, that Tariq can't do. I mean, he's not as good as you are, but he's good enough. And the Bobbsey twins do have to be deployed together. I'd feel uncomfortable separating them. I mean, what good is a Jaina without, I don't actually remember what the other Wonder Twins' powers name was. Honestly, don't. I mean, I know their monkey was named Gleek. I know that, but... Zan? Was it Zan and Jaina? Probably Zan. So I can't send Jaina out without Zan. Gauss rifle, pistol. Actually, we don't want a Gauss rifle. We want a Gauss carbine for you. Gotta help your foot speed, because let's face it, Fatima, not the fastest unit on the table. Aegis armor, Gauss carbine. That's a respectable level of protection. For Tisiphone, and what else are we gonna need then? Gunner, scout, assault. Assault, medic, engineer. So an infantry trooper would certainly not go awry. And I would like to take a sniper. Probably a relatively good quality sniper, now that I think about it. We can't take the Duke. Broadside would level, but I wouldn't exactly call him high quality. What about, we don't have an officer yet, do we? We do not. All right, well, that's the clincher then. We're going to need an officer. It's going to be Franklin and D. Roosevelt. The D is on the case, folks. We're going to deliver the D. Today is the day of the D. And we can give you this Illuminator gunsight, can't we? I mean, you already have Executioner, so again, it's not really that good for you. All right, well, let's give you an alloy bipod. Yeah, let's just stick with the alloy bipod and the high-capacity mags. That's fine. Franklin the D. Roosevelt's actually a good enough shot. He probably doesn't need the assist. Alternatively, we could have taken Edgar Autish Poe, but Steve Lawsuit Jobs is probably good enough to get the job done, especially once we get him really kitted up here. And we can do some fairly nasty shit now with the lawsuit. If we give him, not the cognitive enhancer, but the Illuminator gunsight, can we then couple that with a scope? It can't stack. Wow, that's disappointing. Disappointing, but honestly not unexpected. What about this cognitive enhancer? Is that better than a laser sight? You know, considering it will help us level you faster, we should try and get the cognitive enhancer on one of our lower rank guys every mission. So let's go with the Illuminator gunsight, which is almost as good as the scope and a laser sight combined, and then the cognitive enhancer instead. Let's test out some of these new capabilities, see how this does for us. We got some new toys. I'm playing with them. I don't care. I'm playing with myself, too, right now. I mean, you can't see it because it's happening off camera, and it's kind of disturbing, but man.
Strike one. Prepare for landing.
Perfectly natural. Not ashamed to admit it. You know what else is perfectly natural? Eliminate the fact that we're on the Fountain Plaza map. It's perfectly natural that our every mission occurs on the Fountain Plaza map because every mission happens on the Fountain Plaza map.
We want to slow the spread of panic.
Every single one. Yeah, it's fine. Hey, Bradford, you don't need to be concerned about the spread of panic here, pal. We've been here so damn many times already. I think we've sort of got this one covered. If I'm going to be fully honest, Bradford, this is something we could basically say is in the bag. We've done the Fountain Plaza map so many times, there are no surprises left on this map for us at all. This starting position is...
Strike one is cleared to engage hostile targets.
The word I'm looking for here, I think, is abysmal, but it may seem a little overly dramatic, kind of like I'm trying to oversell on it, but this really is a fucking shit spawn. Especially considering the fact that we have a pod of four, it appears to be four aliens right back there. No effective way to deal with them. Alternatively, we could try and fall back into this area, see if we could set up a long-range ambush. We could either do that or we could just go at them. If we go at them, though, we're largely just saying, hey, we can kill you before you can do anything to us, and that may or may not be true. You know what? For a change, let's play this a little conservative. So we're going to bring Marie the Baker Antoinette over here. She's going to hunker down. I think we slow play this one. For once, we take the smart move, we do the slow play, and I think Overwatch, where applicable, is probably the safer move. If we could get Joan... she's going to be able to see him. I'd love to get Joan of Arc closer, but I'm worried about triggering the pod. Then again, with no pods active, we don't exactly have to be terrified about cover, really, do we? We can't get much closer. In fact, I would say we could probably afford to get no closer without potentially activating the pod. So let's put you on Overwatch. Michael Jackson, we're just going to have you stand right here. You're on Overwatch. Tariq, our medic, let's get you... Yeah, I know you're going to have to dash. That's also safe. Good. Let's get... I kind of want Tisiphone again, still towards the front, so that position she can maybe confirmed. Make something happen with a grenade next turn. So no cover for her either. Mitch Pancakes Hedberg, we're going to bring you right here. We'll probably have you advance to that truck next turn and just body pop this pod, whatever it is. Meanwhile, Franklin the D. Roosevelt will prepare to do the D delivery that he does so well. He's going to head over here. He's going to steady his weapon. All right, well, we've got a pod running in from the right. It is a whole bunch of berserkers. All things considered, we're actually not set up badly to handle this. I don't really want to capture berserkers, but there is a Muton Elite in there, and I would love to get my greedy little hands on that device. We do need to watch if the other enemies activate and collapse on us from this other side, though, because that would be very unfortunate. That did not happen. All right, so we need to know where that pod is. First things first, we got to figure out where those guys are. If they got closer, we have to know. We've got to know. Okay, they did not get closer. I count four. So those berserkers got to die. Fortunately, making those berserkers be dead should not be exceptionally difficult. You got plenty of shots. Franklin D. Roosevelt does not have double tap. He does have a pretty good shot at that guy, though. If we can enhance that shot, however, we should take every effort to do it. The speed demon. Yeah, we're going to be able to do some fairly nasty shit to those guys. Do we need to get into cover? And how determined am I to make this capture happen? That's the question. The real question is how determined and how dedicated am I to trying for this capture? If I want to kill these guys, I kind of need to put the grenade right on top of them. I need the damage, but more importantly, I need to bring them closer so that we get a bunch of free shots from close encounters. I also would want to destroy this cover if possible, but making our shots on the elite, I think we're going to have probably good enough shots at the elite without bringing them closer. So let's take the berserkers down. They're really the bigger threat, I think, at the moment. There's three of them. Some respectable damage from Fatima's guns. Not fantastic, but respectable. These guys are going to move in. We got no free shots, huh? All right, well, I was hoping for maybe at least one or two freebies. Tariq, what's your hit chance here? You have a 19% chance to hit that guy. Well, that's a pathetic joke. Can you kill? You could theoretically kill this guy with a hit. Not a terrible plan. Marie Antoinette, what's your chance like? Not at any of those guys. Double 27s is bad. Oop. All right, so let's send forth the speed demon then and have the speed demon do that thing that he do so well. Which is try and get a free shot on one of these dudes. Specifically the one that's least injured, which is this man. So this is going to be it shredded when he comes at us, assuming we don't panic, which it looks like we're okay. Michael? Yeah, Michael's good. This guy's might be dead. Yep, Michael Jackson has erased him. That was only one shot, I'd like to point out. That was a single shot from the mighty MJ. So let's follow that up with a shot on this guy. Yep, 10 damage and the shred is good. Close encounters. Actually, if we panic here, it wouldn't be the end of the world. Nope, doesn't matter. This guy also dead. So Michael Jackson fell in two of our foes right off the front. That's right off the cuff. That's some damn fine work, sir. Damn fine work. Joan of Arc cannot get close enough for a capture this turn. Unless we were to throw a command at her, which we could do. Assuming we can get that guy injured enough, we could try and throw a command at St. Joan to give... That's going to give us exactly one shot. Exactly one shot. Alright, well, Tariq, let's see if you can finish this off for me. Okay, that's beautiful. So Tariq takes out the last Berserker. A fantastic contribution. We bring Mitch Pancakes Hedberg forward then, and Pancakes, all we need out of you here really is... I mean, a hit would be fine, but really we're just looking for the holo target, and you delivered. If we can't do enough damage to this guy, we may have to disable his weapon. Or we may just have to run up and try and shotgun him. We've got to get some damage on him for sure. Double 37s from Baker. We need one of these to hit, Marie. Got no hits. That's very bad. Lawsuits, double 51s. We're not going to be able to. We're going to have to try and kill him. All right, unless Steve Jobs goes 2-for-2 here. Now that's completely out of the question. Hell, at this rate, we're not going to be able to kill him at all. We haven't hit a single time. All right, well, now things are... Okay, so I guess we'll run and gun then, because now we have no choice. And suddenly, this guy's unhittability is making me regret having thrown that grenade. We definitely should have destroyed his cover and put him out in the open. That's all I'm going to say. 76% chance to crit here. 14 damage is respectable. I don't think we can give her another shot with the running gun, but we've got 81%. If it hits, he's dead. You're the last game in town, though, right? Yep. Franklin D. Roosevelt is all we got, so we got to go for the kill here. Don't you fucking miss. You missed. Unbelievable. We missed so many fucking shots at that guy. It's not even funny. Close combat specialist saves the day once again. I'm ashamed of every single one of you. Literally all of you. You should all be ashamed of yourselves. All of you. Every one of you should be ashamed. All of you should be filled with nothing but shame and grief right now. We had a chance for a Mutant Elite capture, and you blew it. You're just rampant, rampant missing, all of you. Shameful performance, everyone. Except for you, Tariq. I gotta give credit where credit is due. You did a good job. You did a good job. We're green to go. So we're gonna reposition. Everybody's just gonna reload. We know there's still a pod of aliens likely that have not moved. Let's go have Franklin Roosevelt get to reload and re-steady his weapon. Marie Antoinette, might as well just have you reload. Nothing better for you to do. Same for Steve, lawsuit jobs. Just reloads around the horn. Michael Jackson, let's get you away from that flaming cover. Oh, we got another pod coming in on us. Everybody's trying to come in at us from the side. Steve lawsuit jobs with a kill. Well, that's one man who we won't be seeing in court. Get it? See, Steve lawsuit jobs, his catchphrase should totally be like, I'll see you in court. And then he can't because that guy's just dead. I think it works. I'd adopt it as a catchphrase. All right, so the D does not have double tap. What can you do, Tariq? You have not fantastic shots here. Tisiphone can get to a questionably dangerous position in that it might be close enough to spawn that side pod. Kind of need to know if those guys are still over there. If I'm going forward, though, what I'm gambling on is that we can kill every single one of these units before they get a chance to do anything. Why do I keep hitting that button? So jobs, what can you do? 51, 51. Well, if I know one thing, it's that I can't really trust... Why does that keep happening? I can't really trust Steve Jobs to hit a 51%er because he will miss. Alternatively, we could move forward, engage these guys to the best of our ability from a giant cluster and throw the shadow device. That would be our other potential... Cluster and shadow. Cluster and shadow. Cluster and shadow. Goes together like... I can't think of anything that rhymes with shadow. We could run and gun. That gets us effectively one free kill on this guy. It also flanks this guy, which means he's going to be very likely to move. Does that gentleman have... Actually, it wouldn't even matter if he had close encounters. We could still... he's going to be not able to be shadow deviced. I think cluster and shadow is actually going to be more productive from a shadow device standpoint. I think that's our better bet. So let's figure out where everybody... If we're going to go for cluster and shadow, where can everybody get to and still have a method of contributing something? And so let's send a Baker forward. Affirmative. We're gonna oak up around this bench then. This is our spot. The bench is our spot. 82% is pretty good. 77. 62, but that's the guy we would most like to hit. Honestly, yeah, I'm gonna go for this one even though it is lower percentage. Fantastic. Alright, so we got the good old Mind Fray. You can go ahead and intimidate all you want. I don't even care. She can hunker down. Now, we do need to make sure that nobody who's up in the pile, wherever it is that we're going to establish the pile, we want to make sure that nobody up in the pile is on Overwatch. So, let's bring Fatima. I think you're good here. Grenades, always useful. This is going to be minimal damage, but maximal cover destruction, which I am interested in. Let's make this happen. Suck on this. So, a really high lob from Fatima, going for the lob shot. She's been watching a lot of tennis lately, and I think Roger Federer may have inspired her that the lob shot is the right way to go. Now, we're going to do something a little interesting here with St. Joan. St. Joan does have close encounters as opposed to hit and run, which means she can sneak up here, kill this man. Sayonara. See you later, champ. That guy is dead, and then she can still fall back and get into the shadow device cluster, which is exactly the way we're going to play that. Inzi, outsy, she's all done. Now, the question is, do we want to take the run and gun for the kill on Michael Jackson? This guy is mind-frayed. He'll be in the wide open, which means he's unlikely to do anything other than seek cover. It would be both of those units flanked as well. It's an intriguing proposition, it really is. We're going to have some shots here. 36% is not good. 81% is quite good. We will take that. Hey, Jobs, buddy. You know who's getting sued after this mission, now that I think about it? Because I'm pretty sure it's you. If anybody's getting sued, I'm going to sue you for egregious gross misconduct and dereliction of duty. You're fucking it up royal here, pal. We can't afford to leave the D in less respectable cover because he is half cover is full cover for the D. We know it's full cover. All right. We're going to take a gamble with Michael Jackson here. We're gonna take the gambler's move. We're going high risk on this one. Two reasons. One, I mean, high risk is cooler, let's face it. And two, it does put him closer in position for a capture, because this guy is not going to be able to move very far while mind frayed. His movement is going to be very severely limited. This guy is almost certainly dead. 100% dead. That leaves us Mitch Pancakes Hedberg, who's got to throw the shadow device, and Franklin D. Roosevelt now has one shot. Do not miss your chance here, Franklin D. Roosevelt. He's going to miss his chance. Oh, no, he actually did not miss his chance. I mean, he only had one shot, and Franklin D. Roosevelt, for a change, did not miss his one chance.
Yes, Commander.
Wow, opportunity comes once in a lifetime, and Franklin D. Roosevelt totally seized that opportunity. Also, when you're Franklin D. Roosevelt, that opportunity doesn't really come once in a lifetime. It comes like four times a mission. And here's the shadow device. Ghost mode is engaged. Let's see what Team Alien has got up their sleeve. This guy is going to move first, and not very far because of the mind fray. Alright, so he has put himself right in a fuck box. This guy is flanked. He's looking for better cover, and he's going to take a shot at Michael Jackson? No, he's falling back towards help. So we need to pick that guy off, then. Alright, let's see if MJ is going to be able to get close enough for a capture attempt. Alternatively, we want to see if... you are not going to be able to get close enough for a capture, are you, Michael? No. What about St. Joan? St. Joan, can you get in? Can't tell. Actually, I think the answer is yes. I think St. Joan might be able to get close enough. Michael Jackson is not going to be able to get close enough. So, lawsuit, you've got this guy. Double 91s. Can you fucking pull this off at least? What the? Alright, I'm telling you, Jobs. Check the fucking sight on that gun. Because it is fucking off by 35 miles. Oh, you're making me salty, Jobs. You're making me real salty. It's a salty job working with Steve Jobs. It really is. You're making me a salty fucking sailor is what he's doing. All right, so we gotta try and get our hands on a little bit of cover here. I'm concerned that if we send Michael Jackson forward... I mean, I want to do it. It's the right move, but I'm concerned that this flank shot will kill that man. With 13 total health, though, that seems pretty unlikely. What's your hit percent left from Pittsburgh? I say, what's it like from right there? But it's not good. It should be vastly better from here. I'm guessing close to 100%, almost 100%. Even if this criticals, which it is likely to do, I don't think it'll kill him. That was perfect. Left him with one health. We couldn't have asked for better. MJ, will come back to you in just a moment. In the event that St. Joan can't get close enough to throw the capture, we will have you finish that guy off with some hit and run. We are close enough. We go for the 57. St. Joan picks up the stun, Muton Sentinel, taking a little fucking nap. Yeah, he's going to take a little nap now. And I think that just leaves us with, what, one pod left on the map, which is the initial pod. Actually, we have no idea where that pod is. I mean, they were up here a moment ago, but they don't appear to be in that location any longer. No, they're still up there. Okay. So what we should do then with the rest of the team is just reposition and get ready to engage that squad. So let's have Tisiphone. How's your pathing? Should be safe. That gets her close, but not in a line of fire close. Overwatch. Pancakes, we're going to need you to throw the battle scanner, but you can do that from basically anywhere. Let's have you fall back to here then. The D, you're going to reload. You're going to steady that weapon for me. Marie Antoinette, you go back to your initial starting location. You're right over here, and you're hunkered down. Your weapon is full, so that's fine. Pancakes, let's get you on Overwatch. Tariq, honestly, I think maybe Overwatch is probably the best bet for you as well. These guys are finally going to move. It's just a squad. Okay, it's nothing but a squad of floaters. Looks like there might be a heavy floater in their midst. Fortunately for us, they're low to the ground. And Tisiphone is in an excellent position to engage. They're also going to cluster around this car, which is, for them, just a terribly stupid maneuver. One, it gives us things to bounce grenades off of. Two, probably going to explode. So, bad news for the aliens. That was a questionable tactical decision. And we are going to start things off, I think, with a nice Tisiphone grenade. This should not also detonate the tow truck that we are currently using for cover. It should get one, not both. There we go. So one floater is down, one floater very badly injured. Should have some damn fine shots here with the D. The D with a very strong chance to just eliminate the heavy floater. Let's take it. Well, he delivered some small quantity of the D, not as much D as we would like. And Marie Antoinette actually is not going to be able to shoot here. She's going to have to move. We got a little bit of exploding truck action happening, and that's more than a little unfortunate. That's a terrible chance to hit. Jobs, I don't suppose you can do any better. You have literally one bullet left in the gun, huh? Well, if you're only going to have one shot left, let's try and get you in a little better cover at least. One bullet. That's what you brought, huh, Jobs? Steve, one bullet job, they call him. You haven't hit him. God damn it, Steve. No way that just happened. Oh, come on, Steve. Who the fuck are you trying to fool with your no way that just happened? Honestly, that was the most likely outcome. You're not fucking fooling anyone, sir. We all knew that was going to happen.
Can't believe that happened. Except for all the other times that it already totally happened on this mission, man. What a ripoff.
All right, so Pancakes, I think we gotta bring you forward. Probably should have brought Mitch Pancakes Hedberg forward earlier and had him throw some holo targeting on his heavy floater. Might have. Jesus Christ, guys. No one can hit anything. Marie Antoinette is probably going to have to hunker down, and I don't think even the French maid is going to be able to dig us out of this hole we're in. Because it's a fairly significant hole. The French maid could definitely come up here and kill that guy. We got that going for us. If we do that, though, does Michael Jackson have a chance at finishing this guy off? Well, he would if he had run and gun, but it's on cooldown, so the answer is no. We've still got Tariq. There's a 44%, which is frankly terrible. We'd be better off to have... Do you even have a smoke grenade? Well, never mind. I was going to say we'd be better off to have him throw a smoke grenade, but he doesn't fucking have one, so... That's out of the question. Everybody and their dog is going to miss this guy. Every single person. Fan-friggin-tastic. Well, it turns out the grenade was patently the wrong play.
Affirmative.
So Marie the Baker Antoinette is going to bring over, get us some distortion field. She has to hunker down. No choice. That means it's all up to little Saint Joan of Arc, who can kill the heavy floater. She could run over back here and shoot this guy. Oh, Michael Jackson, why are your run and gun not available? Why are it not available, Michael? Why? I don't suppose 18%. That would be the... If we took that shot, it would be the one that hit, by the way. We're in a bad spot. Very bad. We're in a sincerely terrible spot. Alright, we're going to go for the flank action then. I still think this is probably... This is a suboptimal play, but I think it's the only play we've got left. This is almost without a doubt the last pod on the map. I'm confident enough of that to take some really stupid risks, like doing this with St. Joan. He's going to take a kill. He's dead. And I'm relying on... Shit, I was relying on a Tariq fucking smoke grenade, and I forgot that he doesn't have a goddamn smoke grenade. So let's just go on Overwatch and hope nobody gets killed. That guy flies high, which frankly is fantastic for us, because if he had done anything else, we'd have been in complete fucking Hurt Locker. Jeremy Renner movies, not today, my friend, and that guy goes on Overwatch. Alright, well, go ahead and explode, please. Thank you. So let's see if we can kill this overwatching bastard before he gets a chance to actually even shoot at someone who has lightning reflexes. Double 37s. If one of these hits, it's fine. So Marie the Baker Antoinette proving that she can still hit a target. Where is Mitch Hedberg? Mitch, I need you... That guy isn't even on Overwatch, never mind. I was going to say, I need you... Throw a little Overwatch at that guy, but that's patently not true, actually. I don't, because, I do need somebody who can throw a little damage at him. Not a lot of damage, but a little. Honestly, you might be the right lady for the job here, Fatima. Let me see what you can do with a wickedly purposely errant grenade. We're throwing this one off target on purpose, because I want minimal damage. We're looking for Goldilocks damage here. That was just right. Goldilocks delivered. Nicely done, Fatima, by the way. Thank you. St. Joan! Somebody still has an arc thrower. It is not St. Joan. It is actually Michael Jackson. All right, well, MJ should also be close enough to get... Nope, he's not. Son of a bitch. I thought MJ would still be able to get the capture. Otherwise, I would have just straight up killed that guy with Fatima. Well, that's disappointing. Jobs, go ahead and reload. We'll put you on Overwatch just in case. Alright, well, St. Joan, why don't you just walk up and kill him? He could have lightning reflexes, actually, now that I think about it. Or rather, close encounters. I don't really want to take the risk that he does. I really don't want to risk that he has close encounters. Let's have Saeed come over here and take the flank shot for the kill. 64% on the flank. No one can hit anything. This mission has been absurdly missing.
I'm on it, Commander.
Nope, nobody knows anything. Nobody can do anything. Everybody, you're all fucking fired. Except for you, Mitch Hedberg. I mean, all I needed you to do was throw holo targeting at that guy, and you did it. So you're not fired. Everyone else, fucking fired. You guys are making me real salty. Okay, finally. Somebody who can't miss in this fucking travesty of a mission.
Everything by the numbers.
So, no two captures. I would have loved to have captured a heavy floater, because those are good guns. But we did pick up another alien plasma rifle from the Muton we captured. Operation Blind Jester. A complete success. And everybody comes back hale, hearty, and in good health. Which is what hale, hard, hearty typically mean. So, everybody comes back with redundancy, because that's the way I roll. Any promotions? Several.
And not a scratch on them.
Yeah.
Hopefully every operation goes this well.
Don't hold your fucking breath, Bradford. That's all I'm going to say. Killer Instinct, I am not a fan of. Yeah, it's... I would love to get Executioner, actually, at some point on our assaults. But honestly, when it comes to choosing between immunity to critical hits and Executioner, you take the immunity to critical hits 10 out of 10 times. It's just that much better. Revive, I don't care for. Rapid Reaction, eh. Smoke and Mirrors for a grenade we don't have yet. And Fatima should also be pulling a promotion here. Yep, it's just heat warheads for her. Nothing fancy. We do have two people now ready to go to level 3 Psyker, though. Both Fatima and Tariq ready to go get some Psy Panic. Picked up an alien rifle, extra grenade that's completely irrelevant. Floater Corpse, Heavy Floater Corpse, Muton. We did pick up a Muton Elite Corpse, which puts us one step closer. Not to the edge, like a Linkin Park song, but one step closer to tactical rigging. Muton Captive, which is going to make Dr. Valen happy. That's orgasms galore. I'm sure she'll be thrilled. We also picked up 100 credits, decreased panic in Egypt, and got told that we're going to be being watched by the ever-vigilant Optimus Prime, who never misses a chance to observe you while masturbating. It's fantastic. And I'm going to wrap things up with the threat of the looming Overwatch voyeurist Optimus Prime ever present. If you enjoyed the episode, feel free to drop a like down in the comments section. Of course, your support does mean a lot to us. And if you'd like to have Optimus Prime watch you masturbate on a regular basis, you might consider subscribing as well. We post new episodes of XCOM every single day. Right now, however, thanks very much for watching, and we'll see you again soon.